Alright, Elder Band, get what we're doing. For road trip fun. That's right, we are heading to Children's National Health System, also known as Children's National Medical Center, in Washington, D.C. to film the elevator. With the stop at McDonald's on the way there. Crystal City McDonald's. And right, we have stopped light. I would pause the recording. Are about to turn on to Sedley Manor Drive. I'll pause the recording. That's it. Alright, I'm back. That was a quick stop red light. We get ready to turn left onto Lipton Hall Road. This is a fire station. I'm gonna pause the recording. Alright. I'm back. Sorry about this long light that we had. Weird. Heading on Linton Hall and making a right turn to Denver Road. Here we are at the stoplight and we're on to Zeppelin Road. You can see a lot of homes over there. someone that's possibly courting right now. This will be getting gas. And that's it for this trip. Alright. We're continuing the film. Sorry about the long train. I have to stop the recording. Now that we're ready, we're heading to Bristow, Utah. exit that takes you to Seoul Airport. Thank you.
looks like we're in Fairfax now. There's a big truck filled with cars.
Car carrier.
This is a car carrier. Yep, it is. The next to Fairfax and to Indiana Metro Station. There's the South Indiana Metro Station parking garage, and here's the Indiana Metro Station. There's trains that were pulled in. North Vienna Metro Station parking garage. And that's the road that we took when we did a Fairfax trip to 8501, 8505, and 8503. On that old elevator chain. Baltimore sign. Station parking garage, and there's the station of it. This road trip. Let me know in the comments on YouTube. Washington Boulevard.
this is an awesome drive. I think traffic is slowing down, so I'm gonna pause the recording. That's it. Alright. Traffic moving again. So we could move on to the trip.
Looks like we're crossing a bridge.
Okay. Guess I'll stop the recording. Wait. I see something.
Know what it is?
That's right. That is
the
East Falls Church Metro Station.
Here's a metro train coming in to the station.
And there's the tracks which will lead to the underground metro station.
A metro train would be following. The metro train heading to the underground metro station.
There it goes. Now traffic's going faster. be the end of the track. The metro is just heading into the tunnel of this underground tunnel.
Just briefly triggering. I'm here with you all afternoon. one more break, and then after the opera, I'll have a raft of delightful things, including Ray Fawn Williams' Serenade to Music and Haydn's Clock Symphony. So stick around.
Take us with you if you're going out to enjoy the weather, and enjoy the rest of Eugene Onegin.
Welcome back to this broadcast of Tchaikovsky's Eugene Onegin from Scottish Opera. Let's join host Donald MacLeod and commentator Mark Hathaway at the Theatre Royal in Glasgow for the second part of our opera.
Mark, reactions to some of those theatrical coups we've just seen.
Well, you know, what I'm struck most of all is the how cleverly Oliver Mears and how such detail he's drawn the characters. None of these are good characters or bad characters, they're complex characters. It's Olga, who is traditionally somebody who sees the positive side. She's got a lovely, sunny disposition. Here, she's more of a willful girl. Her mother says,
Tatiana is moved by the singing of the peasants. Well, she won't do it. No, she won't go over. It's only through pressure of her mother that finally gets her to comfort Tatiana. Madame Larina herself seems to be very much obsessed with Olga, rather ignoring Tatiana. And it's interesting that in the scene, the letter scene, Tatiana says, I'm alone. And I get that feeling when I'm watching that she is somebody who is slightly isolated in the household.
She lives
in this dream world
of books
that she's constructed for herself anyway.
She does, exactly. But I wonder whether that's her way of coping with life, is retreating away from relationships that really are functioning for her into a world of the imagination and dreams. And then we have Lenski, who is usually upright sort of chap, lives in the country. I feel more that he's oversensitive. In the quartet, Onegin said, which one's Tatiana? I think if it was me, I'd be going for her, not for Olga. Lenski gets very hot on the collar.
I'm
preparing myself for what's to come.
Now we're heading
to Pentagon
City.
His name is George, and he repeated his first night performance of arriving and leaving a very generous deposit center stage with the inevitable reaction that people will have heard of.
We're in Crystal City now.
Not really, we're not one laughter. But
I'm in Pentagon.
But we get first of all through the screen and then him probably riding into the drawing room on this magnificent beast. What does that really do? I think it's rather striking, actually. I rather like it. It's very bold. And it really helps to give us this sense that we're not in a world of reality. We're in a sort of a world of memories where things aren't as you would expect. It's startling. I think the idea is, and I think it works, is that Tatiana is seeing her ideal romantic hero. Here is
Dark.
You have to remember that Tatiana's father is dead. She has no male role models to draw upon. The only one is perhaps Lenski, and he's a poet. There's nothing sort of
We could see a passionate
about him. He's somebody of good humour who likes a laugh, that sort of chap. Whereas Onegin, he arrives, he's withdrawn, he's restrained, he's dignified, and he sits on top.
And there's the Hampton Inn
animal,
a beast with the parking.
Sheer muscle and power, hot-blooded. And I think this is what Tatiana falls for.
There's the
she
hotel.
She thinks, if I can just get underneath that cool exterior, I'm going to find a deeply passionate hero, as I have read about.
Here's
Mark Hathaway, thank you very much indeed. In the second act of Tchaikovsky's Eugene Onegin, the neighbors and local gentry have been invited to a dance to celebrate Tatiana's name day.
And we're
a French tutor,
Monsieur
Triquet,
McDonald's,
sings a song in praise of her. Tatiana hates being the center of attention. Onegin dances with Tatiana, but when he hears guests gossiping about them, he starts dancing and flirting with her sister Olga.
Kempinski becomes furiously jealous. He hurls accusations at Onyegin. He went back down and challenges Onyegin.
All right. We're getting closer to the crystal seeing McDonald. There's the CVS pharmacy. That is nice. And there's the McDonald's. And here we are.
Do food review.
Once we get in. And that's it. Alright, Elder fans. Guess what we're doing in the Crystal City McDonald's. That's right, the food review. We're in the Crystal City McDonald's. We've got the food review. We have the Big Mac, two medium french fries, plain a hamburger, a salad, and 10-piece chicken nugget meal.
Ew.
And our drink. So, time to eat. Then we will drive to the Children's National Health System, also known as Children's National Medical Center. And that's it. Alright, Elder fans. We ate McDonald's. And it was so delicious. You know what we're doing now? That's right, we're driving to Children's National Health System, also known as Children's National Medical Center. Just film the elevators. Here's the thank you. Bye. There would be the road that will take you to the Washington National Airport. There's the Shamrama. There's the parking garage. And the hotel. The Hampton Inn. Since it may take long, I'm gonna pause the recording. And that's it. Alright! Sorry, the little light was, the stoplight was long. We just left the McDonald's. And now we're off to Children's National Health System, aka Children's National Medical Center. Red building. there's another tall hotel. There's more buildings, more office buildings than hotels. Including hospitals. And we're about to get onto the highway over the bridge. The traffic flow, I'm gonna pause for the record. About the slow traffic. We're crossing the biggest bridge in Washington, D.C. We're getting a view. You could see more buildings. There, you would see the Washington Monument. This is an awesome view from the for National Park exit. Guess I'm gonna pause the recording.
for... No, wait. Traffic's moving again. There's construction on the new building. I think...
And that's made very clear by this
And he was a man, remember, who was so restrained and aloof. And we see him in the final act on his knees, begging to love him and take him back.
Small fire hydrant.
By his experiences. Do we sympathize
There's
with him?
There's a church.
I think we need to. And I did feel for him.
In this production, it's clear that he's been through something rather more traumatic than we normally get. And he's in a very odd state, and he seems to be on something,
and
drunk, intoxicated. I don't know.
Yes, he's sort of hallucinating, isn't he? He has this sort of slightly weird scene with the dancer when he seems to be chasing her around as if she's some sort of something elusive that he can't quite grasp.
Isn't this awesome?
Maybe there's a metaphor there that we can pursue. But, this isn't the upright man that we've seen previously. This is somebody who's broken.
You mentioned the dancer. This last act thing begins with a promenade. Very often, that's an opportunity for a costume designer to go to town and show his fantastic uniforms and all that kind of thing. This is not done in that conventional way at all.
No, well, I suppose we're harking back to the dream, to the returning to the memory, the dreamy feel of everything. I have to say, I do miss the chorus on stage. I understand why they're not on the stage, but...
Looks like where you see
the Polar Grandeur of St. Petersburg Ball.
Here's a pool!
And what goes on behind the screen that we see in silhouette doesn't 100% convince me, if the truth be told. There's something that we've lost here. There's many things that we've gained.
We may have to pause the record.
So
that's it.
His friend. He's come straight
all right.
From a ship to a ball.
Now we've got...
I recognize him. Is he still a young fool? A hypocrite?
Oh.
Prince Greymon, a retired general, and his wife make their entry. Greymon's son, Graham Broadbent. He
getting closer to...
Onyegin is astonished to recognize this sophisticated woman as
another playground.
He realizes he's passionately in love with her and writes her a letter. In the final scene, Diana is reading her letter. She has a child. He had a glimpse of a bundled infant as the family appears for a moment. When Onyegin arrives, Tatiana remembers when their roles were reversed. He tells her he was wrong. He's been punished so much. She finally admits, I love you, and he begs her to run away with him. She tells him they can't bring back the past. Her fate is sealed. Here at the Theatre Royal in Glasgow, Stuart Chaplin is coming into the book now to conduct Act 3.
Here's the dollar fund on the door. Here's the bakery. Guess I'll have to pause the recording. That's it. All right. Now we're here. An old Washington, D.C. town. Getting closer to National Health System or Children's National Membership, wherever you want to stay. Here's the Metro Road access car. Here's a bus. Look at all those old houses. I'm gonna pause again. That's it. Looks like traffic's moving again. coming up. Damn. Tough. Looks like we're getting closer to the National Medical Center. For Children's National Medical Center, whatever you want to call it, that hospital. Getting a little bumpy. Hospital. And Children's National Medical Center logo. Will be coming up. Green light. And now we're getting closer and we're parking into the parking garage of the hospital. Looks like there's an event at Children's National. here's the logo of it, and we're entering into the parking garage. And here we are, in the children's basketball parking garage. Something weird happened. We're adding a new park. And they're upgrading the hospital. Here's the security alarm. And looks like we're here. And that's the road trip to Children's National Health System, aka Children's National Medical Center. And that's it.